We just thank God for his goodness today. Today, we'll have a good family talk. A lot of things to talk about. This is going to be a family talk, but I want to just pray. And this is going to be a message that I think that you want to really begin to meditate, because I think this is going to be the key to you actually accomplishing some things that you have long wanted to accomplish personally, as well as others that you are ministering or you are reaching out to. So we're going to pray. We're going to ask God to direct us and anoint us. And I just believe that this is going to be a different type of sharing. Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you that you are God, and beside you there is no other. We thank you, Father, that you have already blessed us with all that pertains unto life and unto godliness. Lord, all that you have provided was all provided as a result of Christ laying down his life. Lord, the work is already finished. We have already been blessed. And Lord, we want to understand how to make those blessings that's already ours, how to make them reality, so that we can begin to enjoy the full benefits of all that you have done through Christ. Father, we give you praise and we give you the glory in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, everybody just say in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, our subject we're going to talk about, and this is designed for you that really want to absolutely begin to build your faith to a level where you can experience complete wholeness, soundness, and healing, both physically, mentally, and spiritually. Amen. It's going to be the Lord's compassion. The Lord's compassion. The Lord's compassion. The reason why I feel led to do this is because I feel that this is true as I see it. I think it was F.F. Bosworth said this years ago. He said that the most readily seen statement in the scripture about our Heavenly Father, in other words, the most conspicuous statement in the entire Bible that concerns our Heavenly Father, are the declarations concerning his love, mercy, and his compassion. In other words, he says that the compassion of Christ is something that stands out throughout the Bible like no other attribute of God does. If you want to probably enumerate the most powerful attribute, the one that is easily seen or discerned throughout the scriptures, I would say, is the fact that God is a loving God, God is a merciful God, and God is full of compassion. And this is what he goes on to say. There is no note that can be sounded concerning that so would inspire faith as this one. In other words, he said there's no other teaching that a person could teach or share that could inspire people to have faith more than the fact that God is a Lord of compassion, God of compassion. God is a God of love. And he mentioned that in his revivals, he saw faith rise mountain high when the truth of God's present love and compassion began to dawn on the hearts and the minds of the people. All right, so this is what he concluded. It's not what God can do, but what we know he yearns to do that builds faith. In other words, God wants to heal you more than you want to be healed. He wants to bless you more than you want to be blessed. Amen. So I want to read these scriptures here because this is the basis of believing God for completeness and wholeness. We have to know that God is a God that's really touched with the feelings of our infirmities. He's really concerned about the things that we suffer. Amen. In other words, the provisions that he has made actually were done on the basis of providing for every aspect of the needs that his children would ever have in this life and also in the life to come. All right, I want to read these scriptures here. Psalms 145, verses 8 and 9. The Lord is gracious, full of compassion, slow to anger, and of great mercy. All right, the Lord is gracious, full of compassion, slow to anger, and of great mercy. All right. The Lord is good to all, and his tender mercies are over all his works. Amen. Those are scriptures, perhaps the most powerful scriptures you will ever find throughout the Bible. That the Lord is gracious. Gracious means the Lord is disposed to show it favor. In other words, God is eager to show favor, to bless you, to help you, to heal you, to deliver you, or whatever need you have. God is not just willing to meet that need, but he yearns to meet that need. He wants to meet that need very, very bad. And